This is a quick video to show you how to get the most out of the Health Reflection Report from the NutriMirror Food Journal. I've preloaded an account here with 7 days worth of foods, and if we want to view those foods through our Health Reflection Report, we just select the days here. So that's one full week. We click Update, and you see that the label here, the familiar Nutrition Facts label format, shows you the average foods or the average amount of nutrients provided by the foods that you've eaten during these 7 days. Now, we have a supplements only here label that has zero everywhere because there were no supplements logged, so we can ignore that. That also means that our food and supplements and our food only labels are going to be identical here. So what you see is a net calorie balance of minus 327. That means this person ate slightly more calories than they burned during that week. So eventually that's going to result in a weight gain. But more importantly for our purposes in this label are these numbers along the side here and how everything is red, just about everything. What this is telling you is that you're way out of balance for these nutrients. Your saturated fat is high, your cholesterol is high, your sodium is way high, fiber is low, all these other vitamins here are low. Now, if you want to get a detailed analysis out of any of these things, let's take saturated fat, for example. Click on it, and you get a brief summary here that tells you how low you are in your saturated fat, how much saturated fat is recommended, how much you ate. So in this case, we ate 7.3 grams too much of saturated fat on average per day. Now, if you look at this list here, this orders all the foods you ate by the amount of saturated fat they provided to your diet. So the top of the list, butter, that's where you got most of the saturated fat. You averaged 8.3 grams per day of butter alone, which right there, that's would put you back in line if you took that butter out of your diet. Now, that's not something we would recommend, especially in this case, where if you go down below, you see a lot of other foods that aren't particularly the most healthy things you could have been eating. That famous star cheeseburger, a banana split, crispy taco, pepperoni pizza, apple fritter, biscuit donut, all this stuff is providing pretty decent amounts of saturated fat to your diet. So instead of eliminating butter entirely, which isn't necessarily a bad thing to eat, you can just cut back a bit on what you've eaten before in these other items. Now, we don't like to recommend you completely eliminate something from your diet because that just causes you to suffer in a way and makes you less likely to stick with these gradual changes that you need to be making. So just cut back, make incremental changes. And this report really helps you to see where you can focus on these changes. If you click on cholesterol, for example, you can see some of these same items show up a lot. That famous star cheeseburger, again, is looking like a pretty good candidate maybe to not eat, or in this case of this person's food choices, they are going to need to make a lot of changes to make things a bit healthier for themselves. Sodium is a huge problem at 245% of what's recommended. The cheeseburger, again, is the top of the list. Lots and lots of other fast foods are on here. Now, a different type of nutrient you're looking at are the types that you need to get enough of, not things you need to eat. Worry about eating too much of. Like fiber here is very low. We need to get that number higher so that we can turn this to 100% where it will turn green. And this shows the same list as before, showing which foods provided most fiber to the diet, but none of these foods are providing all that much when you consider your 24 grams low on average per day, and the one food you ate that provided the most, that hamburger, only provided 1.3. So maybe you need some ideas of where to find fiber in your diet. Well, food source examples. Click the button right there. And here we have a standard list of foods that are high in fiber. Now, these are mostly just beans, so that might not be an option for you. You've got an artichoke on there. You've got ready-to-eat brand cereal. You can also search for more sources, which takes us to a different type of report that we offer. In this search by nutrient report, you can see, you can search our whole database for foods that are high in fiber. In this case, we're looking at vegetables and beans that are high in fiber. You could switch over and look at, I don't know, jams and jellies or particular restaurants or entrees, meals, and side dishes. Let's check, look, pasta, rice, and grains. See what's high in fiber there. Now we've got corn, bran, barley, amaranth, rye, bulgur, wheat. Anyway, you can search our whole database like that. I'll back up to the reflection report here. Now, in addition to what you see here, we have show additional nutrients, which gets you the full list, everything from vitamin D down to potassium if you really want to get into this. But we always recommend focus on the main core items first. So there you go. That is a quick overview of our health reflection report, which is a really, really valuable tool. I really highly encourage those of you who are logging your foods with our food journal to take full advantage of this report. It's a great tool that'll really help you get your choices in line, help you leading a healthier lifestyle in the future.